Good morning and welcome to Kids Zone. Thank you again for joining us today. I said the word thank you because today that's what we're going to think about our hearts being grateful, being thankful. And there's a word called gratitude, which is a mixture of grateful and attitude. So grateful attitude means gratitude. It means being thankful for all that we have. And today, that's what we're going to focus on. Jenny was talking about honouring your parents and saying thank you to them for all that they've done for you. And today, we're going to think about thanking God for all that he's done for us and also thanking God for friendship. And we're going to think about friendship and thankfulness. So as we start today, we're going to sing a song. It's a new song, and we're going to sing it together. And it's all about being thankful and being grateful. So why don't you get up with me and sing and dance along with me to this song? Let's do it. Which are good habits that come from God. What is a habit? Well, a habit is something that we do without even thinking about it. And sometimes we have good habits and sometimes we have bad habits. So a bad habit might be maybe biting your nails. And a good habit we're going to think about today would be about saying thank you. Last week, Jenny talked about honouring our parents, saying thank you to them and appreciating all that they've done for us, respecting them. And a few weeks ago, we talked about not telling lies. So sometimes we can get into a good habit and those habits come from God. So today we're going to think about thankfulness, but also friendship. And we're going to hear the story of two very close friends, David and Jonathan. And then I'm going to show you through the story just how David thanked Jonathan, even after a long, long time. So in the story, I want you to think about, what did David do in order to say thank you to Jonathan for all the friendship that they had? Listen to the story. David thanks his friend Jonathan in a very special way. After David defeated Goliath, King Saul invited him to come to the palace. David would play music and sing praises to God when Saul was angry and upset. This helped Saul to be calm. Jonathan, King Saul's son, became David's best friend. They worked, prayed, and had fun together. They worshipped God in all they did. David was also a soldier for King Saul and was very successful in battle. He had more victories than Saul and became more popular with the people. Saul became very angry and jealous. He wanted to kill David. One day, he picked up his spear and threw it at David. It missed, and David fled. With help from his friend Jonathan, David ran away into hiding. Sometime later, Saul died, and David became king. His friend Jonathan had died too. But there were still battles between David's men and Saul's army. For many years, David's kingdom and Saul's kingdom were at war. David's army was victorious and defeated Saul's army. David was now the king, and Saul's family were exiled. They were thrown out of the city. But years before, David had promised Jonathan to take care of his family. David searched for Jonathan's relatives so he could bless them and say thank you for Jonathan's friendship. Jonathan had one son who survived the war. Mephibosheth was his name. His nurse had dropped him when he was small and his legs were broken. That meant he was unable to walk. David's servants found out where he was staying. They brought him before King David. Mephibosheth was shaking with fear. "Don't be afraid. Jonathan, your father, was my closest friend," said David. "You will inherit your father's land. Your servants will work the ground and bake your bread. But you, Mephibosheth, you will eat with me. You will be like my own son, and you will live in the palace with me forever." David had kept his promise to Jonathan and said thank you for his friendship. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, Paul says, "Rejoice always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." Don't you love that part in the story where David takes Jonathan's son to stay with him in the palace and live the life of a prince in the palace? And why did David do that? Because his heart was full of gratitude. It was full of thankfulness for that friendship that he had with Jonathan. And Jonathan had been so faithful to him. Jonathan had trusted David. Jonathan had put his life on the line for his friend. And David never forgot that. He always knew that he would be thankful to Jonathan forever. And that promise that they made when they were young, David followed up on that promise. He said thank you to Jonathan for all that he had done by looking after his son, That was beautiful, wasn't it? When we follow Jesus, he asks us to be different so that when people see us, then they know that we love God. And we do that by not telling lies, by honouring our parents, by being good friends, by saying thank you. I wonder how many times you say thank you, or you look out and you think, how many things have I got to say thank you for? It might be you thank God for the trees and the nature and gardens. It might be that you thank him for animals. It might be you thank him for your family or for your home or for your school or for your teacher or for your friends. I wonder what you're thankful for today. And if we are thankful, what is the best thing that we can do? We can say thank you. I know that when I'm going through a door and someone holds a door open for me, I'll say thank you. Or if they give me a gift, I would say thank you very much. But sometimes we don't always, we're not always able to say thank you just straight away. Sometimes we say thank you by doing something kind for someone else. So you might want to thank your parents by maybe playing with your younger brother or sister while they make the dinner. Or it might be that you want to thank your next door neighbour for helping out in the garden. And you might go and say, can I help you? Or perhaps it's about taking the dog out when you're supposed to do that. And it just takes some pressure off the family. So all of the things that we can do to say thank you without even saying the words. And when we do that, God shows his love through us. It's a loving thing to thank people and to thank God for all that he's done for us. We're going to pray now, and I want you to think of things that you want to say thank you for. And as we pray, why don't you think of those things as I pray with us? Let's pray together. Father God, we thank you for all that you have given us. We thank you for nature, for your creation, for the birds, for the trees, for the grass, for all of the animals, for our family and friends, for our homes, for our schools, for our churches, and for all of those people who are friends with us. Lord, we ask you that you will give us thankful hearts. And most important, Lord, we thank you for Jesus. We thank you that he loved us so much that he gave his life for us. And we want to say thank you for all of these things in his name. Amen. Amen. And the sun came out just as we were saying thank you. So how good is that? So that's us for today. Thank you for being with us. I pray this week that you'll have a grateful heart, that you'll have that gratitude, grateful attitude, and that you'll just have a blessed week and enjoy your time together. So meanwhile, stay smiling, stay praying, stay active, and God bless you, and we'll see you soon.